Okay, flaming dragon. Fuck face. First, take a big step back and literally fuck your own face!
Amid the gunshots and bomb blasts, hundreds of students ran for their lives, stalked in their own school by two of their own classmates who went on a rampage.
People were getting shot all around me.
There was a guy at a table right next to me and her, and they just shot him and then walked away, and then he was just sitting there in a pool of blood.
Detectives now believe they entered the school through a back door and stormed down the hallways. They cornered students in the cafeteria and the library, where there was nowhere to run. Witnesses say they laughed as they fired their weapons, executing their classmates who begged for their lives.
They were shooting anyone of color wearing a white hat or playing a sport, and they didn't care who it was, and it was all at close range.
Screaming after they'd shoot up something, they'd go, "Woo!"
And under the bed, I found this, which is a squishy, sticky thing that I think is a pussy. And I think he's been sticking his little penis in it and using this. His Stroke It Right jack-off cream. He's sticking his little penis in his fake little pussy.
I'm gonna go. happens, it happened in stages, gradually. It doesn't necessarily, not to me at least, happen overnight. My experience with, I say pornography generally, but with pornography that deals on a violent level with the sexuality, is that once you become addicted to it, and I look at this as a kind of addiction, like an addiction, you keep craving something which is harder, something which gives you a greater sense of excitement, until you reach the point where the pornography only goes so far. You reach that jumping off point where you begin to wonder if maybe actually doing it will give you that which is beyond just reading about it or looking at it.